Hey everyone, I'm Adam Harrington, and if you're interested in locating and harvesting a delicious wild edible mushroom this week, look no further than the Hygrophorus milky, Lactiflus hygrophoroides. Now this isn't necessarily considered to be a beginner's mushroom because it grows from the ground and it's got light-colored gills on the underside. However, if you go through some of these key identifying characteristics, you'll have no trouble positively identifying this wild edible mushroom species. So this mushroom belongs to the larger group of mushrooms known as the milk cap mushrooms. These mushrooms contain structures known as lactiferous tubes. These tubes are comprised of long sinuous hyphae filled with watery or milky latex. In the case of the Hygrophorus milky, if you cut or you break the gills in the bottom, you'll see a copious amount of white latex being exuded. Now that's not the best way to positively identify this mushroom because many milk cap mushrooms do the same thing. So let's look at some other key identifying features. The cap of the Hygrophorus milky is between 1.25 inches to 4 inches across. It's typically dry or finely velvety, dull orange to orangish brown, and somewhat funnel shaped. The gills on the underside of this mushroom are directly attached to the stem. They're widely spaced and they're sometimes slightly decurrent, so they somewhat run down the stem. The stalk of this mushroom is between 1 to 2 inches long, up to about half an inch thick. It's solid and pale orangish brown, and there's no partial veil, ring, or vulva that's part of the stalk. The spore print for this mushroom is white. Now, some things that really help to differentiate this mushroom from any of its potential lookalikes include the widely spaced gills, the non-staining latex, the mild taste of this mushroom, and the lack of a fishy odor. So no fishy odor associated with this mushroom. All those features will help you differentiate this species from any of its potential lookalikes. Now the Hygrophorus milky typically grows in eastern North America under oak trees and other hardwood trees summer through fall, and I have the best luck finding this mushroom in mossy patches. Now interestingly, some research has been conducted on the Hygrophorus milky's nutrient composition. It seems that it's a pretty good source of protein, at least compared to other mushroom species. So in 2013, research found that this species had the highest protein content out of 15 mushroom species analyzed. And the following year, in 2014, the Hygrophorus milky again had the highest protein content, this time out of over 45 mushroom species analyzed. Now mushrooms generally aren't considered to be great sources of protein, but it is interesting to note that this one shines when it comes to its protein composition in relation to other mushroom species. So I encourage you to get out there, see if you can find Lactiflus hygrophoroides, the Hygrophorus milk cap mushroom. If you decide to cook it, make sure you can positively identify it, and definitely do cook it before you eat it. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video.